Chick, Ramona's Plumber here. In a previous video, we determined through a leak test that this toilet needed a new flapper. In this video, we're going to see how to change that flapper and how to make sure we get the right one. First thing we're going to do is turn off the water. Usually on the left-hand side of the wall, below the toilet tank, there's a shut-off valve that's in the off position. Usually turn it clockwise, turns it off. Then we're going to flush the tank and make sure that there's no water in the tank so to get us wet. And then we're going to see, okay, what kind of flapper do we have? I'm going to take the flapper chain off of the flush handle lever, pull it up off the post that it pivots on, get this tube out of the way, the bowl fill tube out of the way, and here we have the flapper we need. We're going to go down to the hardware store and get one just like this so that we don't get the wrong flapper and consume more water than we should. There's many types of flappers down there, so you'll definitely want to take this with you. So you go down to the hardware store, make sure you take your part with you, and you're going to see a daunting selection of parts. And so we want to make sure that you understand what you're looking at and what they got. Take a look here. First, there's a 3-inch flush valve. You would think that looks very standard. Well, here is a 2-inch flush valve. This is what was used between the 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, and most of the 80s and most of the 90s. In the late 90s, middle to late 90s, this 3-inch valve came out, and this became very popular. There's quite a few different 3-inch flappers. They're not all interchangeable, but that's the size difference. And you can see they pivot, but they're just different sizes. Now here is a clear flapper that has an optional part right here. So if you don't have these little, what I call Frankenstein posts, if you don't have these posts in your toilet flush valve, instead you just have this post. You can slide this on. You pull off this part here, and then you slide this on to where the flapper goes all the way down, and you rotate it to where it's perfect. Not offset, just perfectly straight on. And it pivots on that. But now if you buy a flapper like this that has this feature, and you don't need it and you're using these, you must take scissors and cut this part off or your flapper will not work. And it says so on the little instruction card. So just read the instructions on the card and that'll remind you. Another type of flush valve is a 3-inch, but it's the rigid plastic with the seal ring. Now these rings come in various sizes and shapes from different manufacturers. Here's the seal that goes here, and these are just different seals, as you'll see in a second, but this is a Toto Power Flush. There's the standard 2-inch rigid one. A lot of Kohler toilets had this. You pulled the ring off, if it comes off. There's a few that where the ring doesn't come off here, and you replace the rubber piece, and if the rubber piece has a little ridge on it, you pay attention to the owner's manual on the card that the flapper came from and you read the directions. Now some of these, like I said, don't have the ring that comes off. You just have to pull the rubber ring off of the flapper and put your new one on in reverse. Like I said, some of these don't have a removable ring right there, some do. So that's a hard body with a soft silicone ring. The reason for this is that this is very expensive silicone rubber. It doesn't wear out, and it's just be too expensive to make the whole flapper out of that. Now here's a standard 3-inch silicone rubber Toto flush valve flapper that would go on this flush valve we looked at first. Now if you have a 2-inch flush valve, like the standard one from all the years before, and it has the styrofoam ball on it, if you don't replace that flapper with another one with a styrofoam ball on it, that flapper will stay up or close too quickly, or stay open too long and use way too much water. So make sure if you have an ultra low flush toilet that uses a flapper with a timer styrofoam floater on it, that you do so again. Some of them are timer flappers, but instead of using a styrofoam ball, they use a little orifice that goes into the tip of them, and the flapper is such that the water falls out in a metered timed way to get this flapper to close at the right time. Another type of flapper is the one that's more like a ball, but not quite. It still hinges, and that's an important difference between it and the tank ball itself. I'll get to that in a second, but these usually go on the Kohlers, or the old American Standard Ventaways, and they use the two prongs, but they lift up, and they don't lift up very high. They're usually in low buoy tanks. If you've got one of those one-piece Kohlers, that's what this goes in. If you try to put this flapper in another toilet, it'll stay up too long and you'll waste water. This is the lift rod. Now, if you got a toilet from the 20s or 30s or 40s, you probably got one of these, tank ball, and a rod screws into it, and it lifts up and down like this. Most of these are interchangeable. It doesn't have to be the exact shape. It can be a half circle, a half sphere. Most of these are interchangeable. One of the more dying breeds is, this is from like the 30s, 40s, and 50s, and 60s, or maybe not until the 40s, but this is an American Standard. This part you don't want to change. It's brittle plastic. You want to change this rubber piece that it closes with and seals with. This thing here either screws on or snaps on. You can buy the flappers or the seal piece, and you can use whichever one you have. It comes with that adapter part. And you put that on the face of this thing that lifts in the toilet like that. They're a little funny looking, but American Standard had that for years. So that's not all of the flappers in flush valves. That's most of them. There's a few others that are more like... they're more like what I call a potato masher. They're tall, and they're more like a cylindrical potato masher that moves up and down. They use these rings at the bottom of them. If you have one of those, lift it up, feel around down at the bottom, you'll find a little rubber ring. Usually unscrew a thing on top to slide the whole thing off, and you can pull that ring off and get the exact ring, squeeze it on, and you're done. And if you take your parts with you to the hardware store, you'll have a much better time. Now, any flapper here is actuated by a flush handle. And if the flush handle isn't working well, the flapper may stick open or something. So I, as a rule, replace my flush handles when I replace my flappers, unless I know my flush handle is working perfectly. And by perfectly, I mean that it doesn't jam up. It will move very freely. And keep in mind, when you change these, the nuts are threaded in reverse. That means instead of being standard threads, they're backwards threads. And it takes a bit to get them off. But just know that they're backwards. Come on. You see how easy it is? There we go. Now, these nuts, if they're brass, they're on there tight. Don't break the tank. Here's a flush handle that goes on the side of the tank. It doesn't go on the front and lift the flapper. It goes on the side of the tank. This happens to be an Elger one. But there's also flush handles that go in between. Instead of on the front or on the side, there's a tank that's beveled and it goes on that bevel in between. Usually those flush handles are not changeable or interchangeable. You have to get a side flush for a side flush and a front flush for a front and one at an angle for one at an angle. Now I'm going to cover a couple of common mistakes that you'll want to avoid. First one is the flapper that has the optional ring to use if you don't have the posts on your flush valve. Common mistake is that people don't cut this piece off. It says cut right here, and it's in the owner's manual of the flapper, but some people don't cut this right here, and that forces that flapper to close too quickly. It won't stay buoyant, the toilet won't flush. That's definitely a don't do that. The other mistake is using both methods of attachment and pivoting. The Frankenstein posts with the little ears and the rubber ring. Now if you look, you can't see this, you know, when you're looking down in a toilet tank, but we can right here, that this is forcing that to push to, it can't float up, it's not buoyant. And if you do this, you'll have a very, very poor flush, if it flushes at all. Another common mistake is if the flush handle is low enough to where this chain is allowed to have enough slack into it to where this flapper closes on that chain. And it can't seal. The tank's just going to run water. You're going to waste water, and it's not going to flush well, because when you lift that lever up, you'll have to lift it so far that it'll only come up a little bit, but then as soon as you let go, pop, it jumps back down. The correct chain slack is, if it's a chain, about one link, just like you see right there. Just enough so that the chain or rubber string or what have you can move. Just about like that. Not anymore. Thanks for watching. Can you do it? Yes, you can, and I can help. For more do-it-yourself plumbing advice, go to DIYplumbingadvice.com. Thank you.